Hi, I'm Karen. Most of you probably know me as Karen Ballou if you know me at all. But I'm here to talk about hair. And that's why I named this channel All About That Fringe. Truth be told, I'm wearing some helper hair right now. This is Tarani by Belle Tress in British Milk Tea. She's an adorable shag, and she arrived on my doorstep today. So I wore her for a community meeting that I had on Zoom tonight, where I had to put on a tiny bit of makeup and set up better lighting so that I could do a meeting at night. But I thought, hey, why not go ahead and just record a little hello to folks? So hi. Couple things to tell you. First of all, I buy most of my wigs from Wig Studio One. As a matter of fact, almost exclusively now that I know better. They have an awesome return policy, although I try not to return things. I try to wait a few days and kind of let things settle in. Obviously, don't mess with a wig at all if you think that you might be sending her back. But sometimes just putting her on a stand and trying her on, or walking into different rooms with different kind of lighting and different times of the day, can let you know a little bit better about what you do and you do not like. I purchased Tarani with my own funds, and anytime I'm here talking with you, I'm gonna tell you, what I really think and what I really feel. I guess I'm saying you can count on me to be real with you and ask me any questions that you might have. I don't want this to become a part-time job for me or a full-time job. I'm not going to do tons of reviews, but in the past couple of months, I have acquired a decent number of pieces of helper hair. And I thought it might be helpful to have a place, both here and on social media, where I can show you the evolution of a piece. Usually, I would cut bangs into something, which is why this is called All About That Fringe, right? But Tarani, she may change my mind about what I'm doing here. She's got really wonderful rooting. I can't show you close up because of the time of day it is right now. It's a little bit dark. She did come with a tiny little bump in her lace from the way she was folded in the box. And so I really wanted to wear it tonight, so I just popped her on. I put a tiny bit of it stays up here, but I can feel that little tiny bump there that still needs to get trained. And so I'll put her back on a stand, and I have it sort of rigged up MacGyver-like. So I can show you some pictures of that on the Facebook page. Anyway, I digress. I kind of like these long layered bangs, and I think I like that I can tuck or not tuck, and she's kind of cute. She's got this little flip going up and back, but I don't know, the framing looks okay to me without bangs. And you'll find that a lot of my pieces I cut bangs into. Trying now to wait a little bit longer to make a decision about that. Some of them may not get as much of a bang. I only kind of jumped the gun on one piece, and I take my time with them. So I might go with a longer sweep aside, and then it might creep up to about here, sweep aside, and then it might creep to about here. And then it's, let's just get it piecey at that point, maybe wear it up a little bit more so that it's covering my hairline, but not necessarily my final cut. Let her sit on a stand for a couple of days, trim up any stragglers. It's kind of a long process for me to come up with the bangs and the fringe, if you will. That's sort of the final product, my final happy place with any of them. Another thing I should note to you is that I use Karen Ballou on social media because my dog's name is Ballou. And right now he's down there on the ground and he's mooing. So if every once in a while you think there's a cow in the room, it's actually a 14-year-old schnoodle, which is a schnauzer poodle mix. What else do I want to tell you? I think that's enough for now. Not going to go crazy with this. If you like what I'm saying and doing, then hit the like button, hit the subscribe button so you get some information when, I'm and posting, and also on Facebook, All About That Fringe. And you may see me popping up in a few other places on social media, as long as I can make it where it's a one push and it just kind of blasts everything out. I'm, you know, going to be 61 years old in a couple of weeks, and I don't want to dive too deeply into the social media thing, she says now. We'll see. All right, folks. Thanks again for joining me, Wig Pals, and we'll see you again. I'll give you a better look at Tarani in the daylight.